Yeah. What is the fucking the thing from the Three Musketeers? The chastity belt? Was it like a chastity diaper?
It was
diaper
like a giant white chastity diaper. Dude, that's what it was. That's what it was.
That's
bro.
The name of the episode.
Welcome back to True Sailing, episode 33. My name is Joe.
And I'm Jackson.
And we got a first mate on deck.
First deckhand on deck.
First mate.
Introduce yourself, first mate. Someone introduce him if he's not going to do it promptly.
It's Peter.
There's so much energy. It just went from 0 to 10 just now. This is
went
a lot
from 0
energy.
To like 2 and a half.
Been rolling with a 2 and a half.
I guess.
Solid
it's
2 and a half.
It's a pleasure to be here, guys.
Yeah.
Hey, thanks so much for
prop one
me.
Off to that. I will tell you. You gotta,
cheers
you
to that.
Scream into
cheers,
that microphone.
Cheers to that, guys.
Yeah, Nessie's a little sensitive.
Yeah,
or maybe not sensitive enough.
She's
cheers
not sensitive
to that.
Enough.
First
cheers.
Deck hand on deck, first mate.
This is not
fucking,
our first deck hand.
No, not the first one. The second.
Yeah.
We talk about this is our most glorious, glorified first mate, I'd say.
Glorious? You call me the most glorious?
I'd say you're glorious. Dude, you are a hard cat.
You're talking me up. You're talking me up.
You are a fucking. You're a predator, dude. You are fucking.
This is the Peter. The Peter that we've prefaced a couple times.
Yeah, it's fun to watch and hear you guys talk about me too, but briefly.
Yeah. Well, that's usually what we do. We talk about you in passing.
I'm sorry if we didn't do a good enough job of prepping you and really glorifying you. I try to. I love Peter.
Oh, the standards are
I deserve more, but I'm gonna have to deal with it.
So Peter's a really cool guy. He's
Peter,
just all
awesome.
Around cool.
God,
just
he's so sick.
Everything about him is fucking.
What else do
sick.
I do?
Remember how lame our last guest was?
Dude, Colin. Remember
Colin?
His dumbass Luke Combs song? Dude, I hope you have a better music minute.
I don't even know the
Jesus
guy.
Christ.
I don't even know the guy.
You don't need to. You really
don't
need
to.
Want
to. Not many people know him. He doesn't make friends easily, dude. He's a piece of shit.
Thanks for coming on, Colin.
Jesus
so, Peter.
Don't worry, dude.
Shout
you're
out
a
to
favorite.
Colin,
we
bro.
Won't stab
Shout
you
out
in
to
the
Colin.
Back, dude. You're the best guest we're ever going to have. Right? Make
well,
sure you have
well,
a good music.
We have next week, we booked that.
Oh, yeah. Wale from Maybach Music Group. Yeah,
yeah.
You have a guest next week, too?
No.
No.
You didn't
no,
say that,
no, dude. Dude. Who's going to follow you?
Music Minute. Peter, you're up.
What's the music minute? Are we doing that
oh,
now?
We're not doing
no,
it
no,
now.
No.
We're not doing it now. We're not doing it
Does
now.
Does that happen
dude.
At the end?
That happens at the end of the show, man.
You'll know.
Jesus.
You'll
I don't think I've ever
know.
Watched your show to the very
dude,
end.
Dude, is so Colin
not,
available?
I don't know what that is.
Yeah, let's talk to Colin. Let's call in to
calling
Colin.
Colin, we have on hold here. Colin, how do you feel about...
That'd be funny. Cool. I'll tell you, if Colin listened to the show, he would definitely have spoken up by now because we've trashed him like 3 weeks in a row. So you don't
wow.
listen to the show, Colin.
Yeah, Jesus, yeah. Benedict, aren't you fucking
it.
Lobster back?
Yeah.
Betraying us, dude?
Lobster back?
Yeah.
Fucking lobster back, you red coat piece of shit.
Yeah, dude, I'm going to...
Call yourself a true sailing patriot?
You know what I'd like to do, dude? Take a nutcracker and just start dipping him in butter. Crack him open. Because he's a lobster.
You'd probably be sultry.
Yeah. I bet he would.
Dude, the whole... The muffler thing
what
really
muffler
makes
thing?
You look like
oh,
bang.
This? Dude, there's no need for this. There's absolutely no need for this. No, there's no need, man. Yeah, and I'll tell you, everybody's wicked low right now, too.
Oh, really?
So, yeah, I'm going to boop you. And
me in the bottom?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, my God, dude, you can't even see.
Oh, did we just come?
Yeah, you got to, like, you have to basically touch your lips to that
there. All right, are we good?
I think we're good.
All right, we're good.
I'm basing that on nothing.
Okay.
I really have to hold this here, don't I?
You really
yeah.
do, yeah.
Yeah,
all right, cool.
So,
that's good to know.
Me and we worked on the movie together,
dude,
is what I'm
fresh,
trying to say, dude.
We're fresh off
the
a
movie.
Set.
Yeah. You,
for a good month.
You a little bit fresher because you came
fresher
literally yesterday, like, the final
after
wrap.
The final,
you're like
yeah.
a premature
yeah.
baby,
and
dude.
I was exhausting. I'm yeah. premature.
You are prematurely
I guess
fresh.
He's the premature one, though.
I'd say you're a little more premature.
A little premature.
I left prematurely.
Were you a premature baby? I was. By like a couple days.
You look like
by a couple
too.
Years.
Thank you. A couple days. Oh. A couple days. Yeah, it was immaculate conception. A couple years. Dude.
Yeah, my parents
years.
Were
I
like,
"Don't have a father."
That's
He's
it's so
have
weird.
I've
it must have been
that.
A couple years early because my parents weren't married yet. So that I don't know how I would have came along.
I think that means your parents just never got
you,
married.
No. I heard about you somewhere. Someone was talking about that.
Yeah, I did like some miracles. I had these like 12 guys following me around. I'm Jesus. That's the joke.
Just, I just want to see how long
Jesus
that would
wasn't
go just...
2 years of preemie. I don't think that's the fucking lore. No. I don't think
maybe
that's
why he was born in 3 AD, dude. Maybe he was very late.
3 years post-mature?
3 AD, your calendar's a lot.
He was born in 3, man.
What if
check
a baby
it out,
was like... What if your gestation not was much. Fucking... 27 months, and the doctor just kept assuring you, like, you're still pregnant. He's just growing. He's going to be really strong.
Like, just keep waiting it out. Dude, I'll tell you.
Dude, make
this
out
is,
with
this
that.
Has, this has, we've lost Nessie.
Fuck, dude.
Are we good?
How's that sound? Is that good? How's that sound? Is that good?
Dude, honestly, with that
Jamie?
Thing, when I recorded my 18-year-old rap mixtape on that,
yeah,
you literally have to have it on like some kind of pedestal and lean up to it, like you're.
So I have to talk like this into
yeah,
it.
That your okay. your posture has to be.
I can't.
Like that.
So I can't lean back. I can't chill.
Yeah, no.
I learned.
That's
my
why. Do you want to
yeah.
switch?
There you go.
No. It's fine.
But a bing.
We can, just, we can do like a Chinese fire drill of. Seats.
Oh my god, that'll be cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Switch
that'll
right.
Be
go.
Fun
switch
for
right.
Editing.
Go. Switch right. Oh, dude, it's a whole thing. Yeah. I'm not about to get.
When was
up.
The last time you did that at a traffic light, though?
Like, actually did a Chinese fire drill? Yeah. Never once in my life.
Never once?
Yeah,
you've
not
never done
once.
That?
No.
Not once. Dude, have you?
I've only done it a couple times, but like.
A couple
you,
times?
Really?
I would let my friends drive my car in high school and stuff, and we would swap around. Man.
You
really?
Are
yeah,
a
yeah,
trailblazer, dude.
I'm crazy. Yeah. Dude, I would put my car and drive, stand on the top of the car, and let it go right through the. You look like you did crazy stuff like that, though, too, in high school, though.
Yeah, just, but you, it sounded like you were about
ladies.
To say through an intersection.
No. In a parking lot.
Okay. Yeah, that's what
not
I did.
Not through at night, dude. No one's around. It's not, you
dude,
know, at noon
nowhere.
With folks
nowhere.
Around.
You're riding your car a like a goddamn skateboard, you fucking psychopath, dude. Nowhere. I don't care if it's an intersection,
I'll get out
a parking
and
lot,
let her take
the
her
DMV.
Way down, dude.
Let
her do what
she
wants.
Yeah, let's fucking... Jordan LaRiviere, dude, if you're watching, you put a dent in my roof. Dude, he tried to sit on my roof while I was driving.
You
he, like, ran up on my car and, like, crawled up
Jordan.
To the top.
Yeah.
What? Yeah.
Which
that's
car was
fucking
this?
Annoying.
This
dude.
Wasn't the Cavalier, was it?
This was the Ford Focus.
The Focus. You had
the
a Focus,
Focus
before the Cavalier?
I had a Focus before the Cavalier. I had the Focus for 8 weeks or 7 weeks or so.
And
what
then
happened?
He
and
put
then
a
I,
dent in the fucking
and
thing.
Then and then you just had to get rid of it, right?
I'll tell you, I actually lived through the dent. I decided I can probably ride this out a little bit longer. And then I flipped it into a tree.
Oh, fuck. That was
yeah.
that car.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't think you've ever told that story. That's a very solemn... Yeah. Not a podcast story, kind of.
I like
unless
it.
Unless you want to tell yeah. it right now, and then I'll flip
I
mean,
I think
you
guys both
funny.
Know the story.
I do, yeah. but it's a fucking crazy story, dude.
It's
last
like,
time I heard it was years ago, bro.
Really?
I mean, yeah.
Okay. All right, well...
I do know you flipped a car.
I don't know if this story is funny or not, but I was...
It's not funny, no.
No, I don't think it
just
is
a
either.
Very,
you can make it funny.
It's integral
it
to your life.
Make it funny.
Make it funny somehow.
Make that tragic
find,
shit happen. Funny.
Find an angle, bro. This yeah. is
humor
exercise.
And everything,
find an
dude.
Angle.
All right, find an angle and just ride it. All right.
Ride that angle.
So I was leaving my girlfriend's house when I was like 16, yeah, because I just got my license. All right,
you're starting off strong. Like
yeah,
that's the angle. Keep working that angle.
Okay,
that's it.
All right, and then I crashed it.
It was winter, right?
Was that okay? Oh, it keep going. All right.
Yes.
It. oh, yeah. It was like March, and I was leaving her house, and I had a curfew to get home by midnight.
So what time did you leave? Roughly
11:55. That's and I had
not
about
far away.
And I had a 15-20 minute drive. Yeah.
You got to do some makeup there. You
yeah.
got to make up some time.
And so I come around the corner, and like
he
she
still
kinda,
does that, by the way, for set and stuff.
Oh yeah, I'll leave 5 minutes before I got to be there and think. If I you'll go 100, I'll get there on
you'll
time.
You leave 5 minutes after you have to be there, and it's like a half an hour drive.
Yeah,
but
and you're like, sorry, dude,
late,
there was cars
fine.
On the
sorry.
Fucking highway.
Yeah, traffic.
I couldn't
this
do
is
110
kinetic.
Miles an hour. Sorry,
I tried. I really tried.
You're good at making up time, though. I'm just
thanks.
I'm doing. I'm grandma driver, no matter what. So you're making up time.
So I'm trying to. I'm trying to make go four times as fast as I normally would to get home. But
he did
I
did the math. He did the quick math. Before
that's probably
you left.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. 15, 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Reduced to 5 minutes. You have to
yeah.
go about four times as fast.
So she lived at the top of a mountain.
That's a nursery rhyme.
It's a nursery rhyme.
She lived at the top of Unkanunik, dude. She didn't live in like a cabin at the very peak in like a little field cleared out with. She lived at the top of the mountain and like coming down her street, dude. Like you come around this big turn and you can see straight for like a mile and a half, and it is yeah, dude. It is just pedal to the metal, like without thinking about it, and the way it works is like it goes like big slope down and then like a pretty medium sized hill, and then you just assume right back down.
So it's like a roller coaster road. Oh, it's not though. It's not a roller coaster.
It's
like
not a
you
roller
hit
coaster.
That hill and
you're trying to catch air over the hill, or
you hit the top of the hill and then you I can't see from there, but I'm like this. I'm sure it just keeps
going.
But
you've been down this road before.
I've
been
down
this area.
Yeah, but not enough to be like. My spatial reasoning was off.
Okay, sure.
And
because you couldn't see it.
So I'm listening to A Day to Remember. It's 2011. I'm listening to All Signs Point to Lauderdale, which is I hate this town. It's so washed up. Yeah,
like
you guys
all
know
signs
it.
Point to Pinardville, baby. I'm gonna fucking gas this baby.
Here we go. Yeah, dude. Without the I looked down and I was like hitting 120 as I was
dude,
coming.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Yeah, as I was coming up the hill, dude. That thing cooked, that and that's as I was coming up like that bottom like Nike swoosh lip.
You hit that Nike swoosh.
Yeah, and I hit the top of the hill, and that's just gonna happen. That's just gonna happen. Sorry, and I got some air off the top of the hill. Like, just enough to be considered, like, getting air. You know what I mean? Like, quarter second off the ground.
And your stomach drops, and you're like, oh.
Throat.
Yeah.
And, like, the next thing I know, I see a sign whiz by my head and think, like, I don't remember what that sign said. Like, I know, I didn't see it now.
Dude,
but, like,
120 miles an hour is not reading speed. You're
no,
not gonna
it just, whoosh. No. It went right by.
Especially
welcome
on a B road, bro. Like,
as it turns out, it's a sign for S-turn ahead.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Very valuable sign.
Very
that's
valuable
sign.
Sign.
Yeah, one of the most important, some would say.
So I tried to slam on the brake and do the S-turn, just like, I'll Travis Pastrana drift my way through this. And it didn't happen. Like, I hit my head, and, like, snow started coming in from the top. And then...
did you have a sunroof, or was it just...
Nah, like, ripped a hole in the top.
Rended
of the,
a
yeah.
fucking hole in the top. Oh,
and it was just crushed, too. So it was, like, coming in from the side and whatever. And... next thing I know, I'm outside of my car in the middle of the street looking at my wrecked car, still listening to All Signs Point to Lauderdale, and there's this like terrible smell, and there was like dust and smoke coming off of my car, and I was like 100% convinced that I died. Like that
you thought you had like transmigrated to like a ghost body and you were watching the scene.
Yeah, I was like I was very convinced like I can't look in the car cuz my body's in there.
How and, long like, did you Dude. So you were unconscious. If you,
I must have, I must have just blacked out. I don't know because the song was still playing. So it was like
oh,
less
same
than,
song. Yeah.
Less
how
than
far were you
minutes.
From the car? Was it like
maybe like 20 feet?
Damn.
Like
bro.
I was just not even like 10 feet, 15 feet. Like I was standing on the edge of in the middle of the road, looking at my car that had just gone like just off the road and into a tree.
And like you're, did you say you're fine? Basically,
I was fine.
Other than thinking you were a ghost.
Other than thinking
you were
temporarily
dead. Thinking
yeah,
you were a ghost.
Yeah, I was fucking freaked
dude,
out.
Dude, you are
man.
So lucky, oh dude. God. Every time yeah. I hear that, I feel like, dude, that's a near-death experience. That's yeah. like a bona fide. That you are so fucking lucky, dude.
Dude people have so died convinced. Doing like half that speed and getting yeah. into car crashes, so that's insane, man.
I picture your car. Like, you know when you like, you ever like roll your ankle where you just land on like the side of your foot and fucking... Yeah. That's what you rolled your car. You fucking, yeah. like, you caught air and twisted in mid-air, dude, and fucking...
Well, no, bang. It was like I, it's like I landed first. It was like
and
I,
then just cut
I hit
hard.
The ground, and then the S-turn was there, and I was like, well, here we go.
You probably tried to take 120 miles an hour of fucking momentum and air, like a foot of air, into an S-turn. That's just scientifically what you did.
It didn't work, I'll tell you that, too. My experiment failed.
Oh, it was a project.
It was a little thing I was working on, and it didn't work.
That's you're fucking
that's also
very
like,
lucky, dude.
I walked away from there and was like screaming for help and whatever, and landed in some dude's front yard. And he came out and gave me his phone, and then from his front door, I heard "Dad." I looked over, and it was Jamie.
That's so crazy.
That was Jamie. Yeah,
that's the beginning of the
story,
Notebook,
man.
Dude. Yeah. That's
sometimes,
like the alternate beginning.
Sometimes I tell people that's how I met Jamie. If I've ever told you that, that's a lie. I knew her before
that. That's how I met
that.
Jamie, man.
I knew
I
her
almost
before
died
that.
On her
that's
front
how you
lawn.
Became associated with her.
That's how I
that's
got
how
to,
you got close to her.
That was probably my third time meeting her, which is a pretty, I would say third impressions are pretty important.
Yeah. Three strikes,
and
you're out if you fuck up that third time.
Yeah. And I didn't. She thought it was very cool.
Oh, you're a badass, man. You totaled a car.
That's so, dude, that's the plot of Back to the Future. It's like yeah. You start convalescing. Like, she nurses you back to health in her bed. She's like, yeah. Well, you're already in my bed.
And she was able to get son. That attracted to her son.
You're then, Jamie's son. Now you guys are...
I never thought of it like that, you guys.
No, but that,
oh my God, really, you guys.
Eye opening when you put it like that.
You guys.
Did you guys ever have, you definitely had a couple casts, huh? You had some paper mache on your body.
Dude, I haven't had a single cast, and you if I ghost- told you that, it's a lie.
You haven't?
No, I haven't.
You
well,
skateboarding on cars?
I did
you
have a
using
brace
cars for skateboards?
Because I like messed up my wrist. I did like I flipped over on a bike, and I... caught myself and I like sprained my wrist,
but not broken bone.
No broken bones, I don't think at all.
Have you had a cast?
Yeah,
how I broke many? My toe.
Four. Yeah.
Wow.
I didn't know that. I just
wow.
guessed.
Yeah. Zers.
That's where? Probably. My left wrist twice. My left foot. And I was counting the wiring my jaw, but I don't know if that
really
counts.
That transcends cast. That's like it's, fucking body altering shit.
Yeah. So this arm. So it is four because I broke this punching Beaumont in class.
It's a good reason to break your fucking finger.
Yeah, dude. I did a boxer's fracture. I had to wear something that was called like a. It was called like a Gilligan. It was. Yeah, it was
you
like
know,
a
taped your fingers together kind of thing, and
yeah,
like a,
it was like
a metal piece on it,
like Gilligan's Island, like a lobster.
It was something like that. I don't know, man. It would like maybe that's what it comes from. It wrapped a couple of fingers together and splinted them, and then you casted over that.
Oh, I can kind of picture that. Yeah,
yeah. It was weird.
A goompus.
I think it was a goompus, yeah.
Not a Gilligan.
There's so many damn words for these things, man. They're just like.
Cast.
Cast.
When people like to invent stuff, dude, they love naming it after themselves.
They love, dude, Americans especially, I think, bro.
Yeah.
We love naming things. I'll say that.
Yeah, to stumble upon something.
I think it's like a Germanic shit, because there's a lot of like German shit. Like the whole, like the Heisenberg. I don't know. Mm. A lot of Germans are fucking
Germans
throwing their names on shit.
Yeah, they're guilty of
but
it.
But you don't
Einstein.
Get many like Asiatic fucking, like you would never hear like, oh, that's a Miyamoto. I think that's the guy who made Godzilla. I'm not too sure, but they don't have many products that are like, oh, dude, can you pass me that Miyamoto?
Is like a Honda someone's name? Toyota?
E-Honda was a character in Street Fighter.
E-Honda? Electric Honda? Is
no,
that what
E-period Honda. He was like a hidden character or something. He was like the last guy.
Did it stand for Electronic Honda?
It was probably 91, 92, maybe. I don't know. The CEO sense. Of Honda is just a big sumo guy in a diaper doing kung fu and shit.
Surprise, it's me. Hello. So you're probably wondering why you're just hearing me. I don't know. This is going horrible, man. I hate doing these alone. So we had, in case you couldn't tell from the massive cuts and like Peter going silent a lot, we had a lot of technical difficulties on this episode. Trying to get interviews or guests or whatever you want to call it is hard given our setup. So we just have been facing a bunch of difficulties with it. We just like lost the last 15 minutes of this. I don't know where it is. But it's just gone. So the easier thing to do is to just say, sorry, it's gone. Hope you guys enjoyed having Peter on. But before we like go, we got to do the music minute. So I still wanted to add the songs that we did from the music minute. I go first with the music minute, don't I? Man, this sucks doing this alone. This feels really awkward. This feels very weird. This just doesn't feel like the same thing. So I'm going to go with a couple different Father John Misty songs, dude. I'm going to go with The Night Josh Tillman Came to Our Apartment. I'm going to go with Fun Times in Babylon. And I'm going to go with Holy Shit. A couple different Father John Misty songs. I'm acting like this is the first time. That's what I said. I already did this. So they're good. They're, I don't know, I've started to get into Father John Misty a little bit lately. What do you got, Jack? So, I'm Jackson. My voice is a little bit different than Joe's, but I don't know exactly how to do a Jackson impression. I think it's kind of like this. whatever. That's so stupid. So Jack picked Down and Out by Kanye and Cameron, a song I don't know. Bankrupt on Selling by Modest Mouse, which is a song I don't know. And Never Going Back Again by Fleetwood Mac, which is a song that I probably know, but not by name. What do you guys think about my outfit right now matching the acoustic foam behind me, if you're watching on our YouTube? So check that out. Huh? That's pretty cool, huh? Very cool. And Peter had a music minute. Now, I haven't asked Peter what his was, so I'm going strictly off of memories. Jesus Christ. Okay. Okay. I'm going to get two of the ones that he got. I don't know if I can get all three. Okay. They're all by the Avalanches. I know he went with Frankie Sinatra, and he went with Noisy Eater. We'll just leave it there. They're both fucking awesome, weird songs, though. Like, check this out. That's the Avalanches, baby. Whatever. That's Peter's music minute. That's my music minute. So now that we've interviewed Peter, as always. Yo, but for real though, we recorded an episode last night that should be coming out, a week from today, I'm guessing, depending on when you're watching this. Probably next Tuesday, which would be the 13th or whatever. Who cares? We should have a new one out then. And in it, we talk about, we're trying to expand our whole thing we got going on right about now. So, trying to expand our YouTube a little bit, which is a little exciting. So next week we'll probably have an episode and a video, not just like a video of the episode. You know what I mean? Like a fucking separate video, and maybe that'll just start to become the norm. Who knows? All right, guys, thanks for listening, and thanks for listening to me be a fucking asshole on my own. I feel really awkward doing this by myself, so I really appreciate if you listen to this. I also appreciate if you couldn't listen to it, because I don't think I could or I will be able to once I have to sit down and edit this. Thank you guys so much. Get off the fucking boat.